Hi, and welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 70-467, which is the second exam in the MCSE for Business Intelligence. It's Designing Business Intelligence Solutions with Microsoft SQL Server 2012. And once again, we have Matthew Roche with us.
Thank you very much, Jay. It's a pleasure to be here.
So, Matthew, you are a senior program manager for Microsoft today, but you have a lot of BI background. Tell us about it.
Yep. I'm working on the SQL Server team today as one of the program managers building the features that are in 2012, SQL Server 2012, as well as future versions. Before I joined Microsoft, I was a business intelligence and data warehousing consultant and try to bring that real-world experience into the team each day.
Great, and that's what we look for, and that's why we have subject matter experts, sometimes literally around the world, come in and help us design these exams to make sure that they're real world and relevant to the folks. So other exams are very implementation-based. This is a design exam. Can you explain what the difference is?
Yep, absolutely. As we saw on the 463 or 70463 and 70466 exams, The implementation exams tend to focus on how do you do specific things. So if you think about being a business intelligence developer on a team, you're often given an assignment, build this dimension, build this report, build this integration services package. This design exam, the 467 exam, focuses on not how do you do things, but what should you do and why to solve business problems. If you think about your career development, typically you start out as a line developer. You're working in the trenches, writing the code, building those BI artifacts. But there is someone giving you guidance on what you should do and scoping out and designing the entire solution. This exam covers those design skills. You're posed with a business problem or a business requirement. You need to understand which technology you apply, how it's configured. It's at a higher conceptual level.
So how would you see this particular exam fitting into that overall MCSE track?
Well, in many ways, it's the capstone. You can take the exams in any order.
Sure.
So if you're actively working as a BI architect or BI designer, you know, someone who is the lead driving the designs for your BI solutions, you may very well want to take this first. But I think it's more logically a capstone. Once you're done with the implementation,
yep,
you see all the pieces and how they fit together from a tactical perspective. You step back and look at the solution end to end.
So one of the things that this exam also covers is planning and designing the BI infrastructure itself.
Yep.
Can you talk to us about that? Because a lot of candidates struggle with that.
So it really, again, comes down to having this holistic view. This includes things like performance, scalability, and security. So imagine, you know, not simply being asked, build an integration services package to move your data from your source system to your staging database or from your staging database to your data warehouse, but you may be asked to have the data inside your analysis services cube be fresh to, you know, a certain degree, you know, within 10 minutes or within one day, whatever the business needs may be. And you will then need to understand what stages are involved to get it from the source systems, what your, you know, restrictions are, and then how do you apply the technologies to make sure that you're only moving and only refreshing the data that is applicable. So it may be partitioning, it may be choosing a model such as MOLAP or ROLAP or HOLAP for your analysis services cube.
Okay.
And the folks who are taking this exam, Jay, they will know what those acronyms mean. But you need to choose it, understand how to apply it, and pick and choose what the right technologies and what the right approaches are for the business problems that you're posed with.
Okay. Reporting is another thing that this exam covers a lot, but yet we've covered in a bunch of other exams, specifically 467. So what's the difference?
Well, again, the key thing here is that you're not choosing a tactical approach. So 466, you may need to know how to build a report, how to build interactivity into a report, you know, the actual building of the report itself. Here in 467, you need to know what reports to solve what business needs. Perhaps something like choosing, do I deploy based on the business requirements?
Mm-hmm.
Do I deploy reporting services in native mode or SharePoint integrated mode, for example?
One of the things that a lot of people ask is, I see SharePoint on this exam. This is a BI exam. Is it really fair to ask SQL folks about SharePoint?
Oh, that's an awesome question, Jay. And the answer is yes, this is a real-world exam. starting with SharePoint 2007 and SQL Server 2005, Service Pack 2, SharePoint and SQL Server BI have been moving more and more closely together. It's rare to see a real world modern BI application that isn't based on SharePoint or incorporating SharePoint in some way. Absolutely something that we should test on.
And that's part of the solution. This is MCSE, that S stands for solution in that, that whole track. So let's close out with ETL. What does that stand for, and why should I care?
So ETL is extract, transform, and load. This is how you get the data from your source systems into your BI infrastructure, or BI solution. One of the things that is a key thing from a designing perspective when you're building an ETL solution with SQL Server integration services is making sure that you've planned in advance for deployment. This is something that has traditionally been sort of a catch-22 in integration services, where the ways that the tools make it easy to build your solution don't lend themselves well to a reproducible deployment from your development environment to your test environment to your production environment. You know, something that in the real world in a modern mature application you need to consider. SQL Server 2012 introduces the SSASDB catalog, so a new server execution model, deployment repository, and so on, which makes this easier. But you need to understand for this exam, how do you plan your solution, and how do you plan for deployment from advance or in advance right from the beginning? So before you start building your packages, you need to start asking yourself, how will I deploy them? How do I design configurations and parameters and other things to make them deployable in the real world to solve those problems?
Well, that sounds very interesting and something way above my head. So thanks for being here, Matthew.
Well, thank you very much, Jay. It's a pleasure as always.
So we've been talking about 70-467, which is designing business intelligence solutions with Microsoft SQL Server 2012. And it's part of the MCSE for the BI track. And go out and take that test.
Absolutely.